Hey everyone, my name's Silver, welcome back to my channel, and today guys, I'm here to talk about something interesting. Well, interesting to me, maybe not to you, I don't know, that's why I'm doing the video. Today guys, I'm here to talk about Bushiro's new format to the game. So, about, I want to say once every season in G thus far, roughly, they've made a new format how to play the game. And this really isn't a new format per se, but it does look like a better revamped version of when it first came out. I'm talking about the 2v1 fight rules. So this is a format that was introduced last week in the episode, the gestures in the gesture fight between Aichi Sendo, Kai, and Noah, or Chaos Noah as I like to call him. And they've released how the rules and everything works, so I'm going to review it, tell you my personal opinion, and rate this format on a scale out of 1 or 10 at the end. And you guys can tell me what you guys think down in the description below. So the 2v1 fight is very simple. The person who takes 9 damage first loses the game. The two man's team damage counts together, so if someone has 5 and the other person gets 4, that team loses. And that's pretty straightforward. That's normally how most tag teams work. X amount of damage for tag team equals death. And I really do like the turn order. So the turn order is as follows. Player A, so the first person on the first player team, then the single player, player B, single player, player A, and then single player, player B, single player, player A, and so on and so forth. They also added in the rule you can only attack the player who took the previous turn. Which is good and bad, because it restricts a lot of things for a certain person, etc. Certain control decks are going to have a problem with this. It also limits the skills to that previous player. So like retiring, lock, etc. can only be used on that player. Which again, isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it's not necessarily a good thing either. Decks like Nurikami that target all cards on the field will affect everyone, to my knowledge. Two-person team rules, you can pay for the counterblast with your partner's cards, and you can G-guard and use cards like that to guard your partner as well. Other than that, there's not much really left in the rules of that department. There's a few things I thought they need to address, but I think it's all good. Nope. The when you can fight. So when is the first attack allowed? Normally it would probably be this moment. But I think as soon as player B goes, we'll call that player C. Player C can attack, and then player B goes. Can attack player. That makes the most sense to me, because if you have to go ride, 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 and then I can attack at grade 2, there's really no point for it. It should have just been A, B, single player can go and attack, single player might as well go again, whatever. It just doesn't make a lot of sense, so it makes sense that can attack from that point forward. I don't read Japanese, so if this states that, then I can't read it. But that would be my really only question I need answered. Other than that, it's not a bad system. This allows people that are teaching other people how to play and get into the game a viable source. Yes, it might sound complicated, but this is something I would use. I can put myself, or it's two people I'm teaching. That way they can work together and get a grasp of the game. Or if, you know, you're good and you want to challenge yourself, this is another way. Or if you're just one of those people that has a friend that wants to learn and has a friend that wants to play, this is another way you can do it. It just allows you three people to play. And honestly, you could probably turn this into a 1v1v1. A 1v1v1. Yeah. You can turn it into a free-for-all match with this simple rule. Player A goes, player B goes, player C goes, and can attack. Can only attack the prior person, and those rules could apply. Maybe. I would have to think about that a little bit harder when I'm not half asleep. But no, I do like this format. I do have to agree with a lot of people that the table that Ibuki summoned in the movie was much better, but I do like this format, and I do plan on playtesting it with people and seeing what they think. And yeah, overall, I mean, this video isn't too complicated. I wanted to post something Vanguard related since I haven't really done that in the past week. But yeah, tell me what you guys think. I would rate this battle system, because I'm going to be reviewing the other ones in other videos. That's something else I'm doing. But I would rate this one on a scale out of 10, I'd give it a 7.5 or an 8. Overall, it was not a bad fight system, and honestly, it's probably one of the best I've seen. Although my favorite is the line battle format, where it's a team of three, and you go down the rank until each player has lost. And that is by far my favorite format, and I will be discussing that in the next video of this style, the fight rules. Because this is something I want to get more out there so other people know. This is a format, and it is a fun format. But until next time, guys, I've been the Silver Wolf, and I'll see you all later.